Kelsi here for WrestlingNews.co, and I'm with SCU.
You said it right. Yeah.
Pretty good.
I tried. Not from there, but really like... really like it there.
It's a great place.
We like you anyways. We like you anyways.
Thanks. I'm not the worst person you ever met, hopefully.
No, not at all.
So you guys are the first tag team champs. Just talk about how cool that is, the experience of winning the belts and being the first ones.
You know, it's amazing. For me, it's especially amazing because I wasn't even going to be in the tournament originally. I had to step up on, just a hair's notice. And luckily, I had a great partner that I know very well. And we had the support of Christopher Daniels all the way. And first AEW World Tag Team Champions. 20 years from now, you'll be able to look back and you'll see Frankie Kazarian and Scorpio Sky. It's quite an honor.
It's pretty cool. What do you feel about it?
It's very cool. Like I said, you know, I've been doing this 21 years, and to be the first of anything at this stage of the game is very cool. And being a tag team champion, especially for this company, is something I don't take lightly or don't take for granted. And make no mistake, we want to hold on to these titles for a long time. But like Sky said, this is going to be in the history books. You can never take this away from us. I'm extremely proud of all of SCU. I'm proud of the Cinderella Man for stepping up and got our first title defense tomorrow night. And we're going to prove to the world why we are the best tag team in the world.
Maybe 20 years from now, we'll still have them.
Maybe.
We'll see.
We'll have to see about that, but you guys truly are a great tag team, and you're in a company that's known for tag team wrestling. I feel like AEW, that's one of their cornerstones, rightfully so, because the Bucks are founders of AEW, and I think that's even more important in this company than anywhere else right now.
Yeah, you know, in a company that came right out from the very start and said, we think tag team wrestling can main event. As a matter of fact, we main evented when we won these championship belts. And, you know, you've got the Young Bucks. You've got a lot of other guys. This is the best tag team division in the world by far. And it's good to be right at the top of it.
Yeah, I'm glad to see you guys there. And you mentioned Christopher Daniels earlier, and then he gave his blessing for you to step in. You know, the three of you, since you've been paired together in Ring of Honor, just the chemistry was there right away. Talk about coming in and joining Frankie and Daniels, and you know how unique that was, but how you just gelled with them right away.
Well, you know, the biggest thing for me was to not get in their way and to blend in as best as I could, because they teamed for so long, they had such good chemistry that I didn't want two things. I didn't want to come in and mess up their chemistry, and second, I didn't want to come in and be, oh, there's Frankie Kazarian, Christopher Daniels, and that guy that they have with them. So I really tried to work hard to be their partner and not their dead weight that they're dragging behind them. And they definitely helped me out a lot, and the gelling just came so naturally and great, and I think traveling together and knowing each other years helped along.
Yeah, how'd you feel about Sky stepping in and just gelling with you and Daniels?
Well, the thing is, I knew Scorpio Sky was one of the best wrestlers in the world 10 years ago. I've known him a long time, and he was one of these guys that for whatever reason just couldn't catch the break that he deserved. There were people less talented that got to higher levels that weren't putting in the work, weren't as talented, didn't take it as serious as this guy. So when the opportunity came up for us to have a third, he was the first person and the only person on the list. And he talks about not worrying about getting in the way. There's nobody else that could have fit in with what Christopher Daniels and myself have done better than him. He's a brother, he's a friend, he's a fellow tag team champion, and the whole dynamic of SCU changed for the better when he got into the mix.
Speaking about the dynamic changing, I think a big part of that was being the Elite. Being the Elite, I think, gave you guys a spotlight and a platform to kind of transform yourself from the addiction to the trio of SCU. And you guys have been such a great part of that show, Rocky III spoof. Talk about making that spoof and just being a part of being the Elite in general.
Spoof, that's how we train. Yeah. That's how we train. What do you mean, spoof? We always run on the beach trust like that. Come on.
Well, you know, I was just thinking, from what it sounds like, do you think that we're a great part of being the Elite?
Yeah, definitely.
Do ya?
I do.
Being the Elite has been such a huge, transition for our career. I mean, that's what really took SCU off. The fans getting to see us, see our personalities come out, and getting to see us talk, and it's not even that much about the wrestling. I mean, people knew that we were good wrestlers, but they didn't. Not everyone had a chance to know who we were, and our personalities, and our sense of humor, and our hatred for every town that wasn't Southern California, and that exposed us on being Elite, and we're just so happy that people enjoyed who we are.
I feel like that tagline really helped you guys get over just organically. People love that line. They love to say it along with you. How did that develop? I mean, obviously, you love SCU, but where did you think of that?
Well, Matt Jackson decided to put us on being the Elite and basically wanted us to just do what we do, just get on there and be ourselves. And I've got two of the most creative guys, not only in the ring, but verbally as well. So I didn't even want to try to get on their level. So I just said, yeah, hey, I'm going to let you guys be creative, and I'm just going to say the same thing every time. And, you know, it started out, you know, if you look at the first few episodes, I'm like, this is the worst town I've ever been in. And then obviously as it caught on, eventually it was, this is. And, you know, what speaks for it is I was like maybe 498 on the PWI 500 before that line. And here we are 2 years later, and I've dropped like 200 and something categories. So it's a kind of a joke I always bring up.
It's a great line. It's helped a lot. So you guys, like as I mentioned, the first champs, who do you look forward to facing in the tag division?
Well, there's two gentlemen sitting right here by the name of Santana and Ortiz, and it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when, because those guys are white hot, just like every other tag team is in AEW at this time. Of course, the Young Bucks, probably the best tag team in the last decade. Anytime we get in there with, well, the two teams we're facing tomorrow night, Private Party and the Lucha Brothers, you got just a plethora of teams. You got the Jungle Boy and Luchasaurus. There's so many, but you know what? Being fighting champions, we want to fight any and every team out there, and we intend on doing that.
I'd like to see you guys Jurassic Express. Think that would be a good matchup, too. That'd be a lot of fun.
You know, I think the AEW tag team division is probably the most stacked division in all of professional wrestling right now. So
agree.
We're going to face everybody at some point. They're all going to get their shot, and they're all going to go down.
Well, will they still have these belts in 20 years? I guess we can only wait and see. But thank you, guys. This is Kelsi again for WrestlingNews.co. Appreciate your time, guys.
I'll see you later.
I'll see you.